day. He opened my eyes to see the sunshine. I'm gonna have a good day. Put my feet on the floor, walk out the door, share the joy of the Lord. A better day than before. I'm gonna have a good day.
Satan showed his plan. He took the animals Job had on his land. He took his sons and daughters and worked hands. But Job fell down and praised the Lord again. Well, now that just got old Satan riled. It touched him to the quick. He said he can live without those things, but let me make him sick. So one more time God gave the devil his way. He said spare his life, but do just what you may. From head to toe, he touched Job's skin that day. Curse God and die is what his wife did say. But Job had the faith to move mountains. Job had the faith to go on. His love for God, a never-ending fountain. His love for God, a never-ending song. He said, do you think we should leave the bad and take the good? Job had the faith to go on. So finally, as some time had passed him by, Job began to sit and wonder why. Through all his pain and grief, they heard him cry, how can I have patience till I die? Then in a whirlwind before his eyes, the Lord God did appear. He said, my dear Job, don't question me. There's nothing for you to fear. So everything of Job's got multiplied. He blessed him with possessions far and wide. Now if you ever have your patience tried, and like Job it boils down to being tried, just remember that the Lord is watching you and trust him with all your heart. Your life is under his control and he'll never ever part. Job had the faith to move mountains. Job had the faith to go on. His love for God, a never-ending fountain. His love for God, a never-ending fountain.
never-ending song. He said, do you think we should take the bad and leave the good? Job had the faith to go on.
Never felt I'm thanking him for. Every day I live, I just love him more. I'm so grateful for all he has done. And I got a feeling I'm not the only one. Singing his praise all day long. Don't you know I love just singing this song. Never in all my born again days have I ever felt more like singing his praise. If you've been saved and you know it for sure, and heaven is promised for those who endure, you know it was Jesus made you whole and new. And it's gonna be Jesus that take us all the way through. Singing his praise all day long. Don't you know I love just singing this song. Never in all my born again days have I ever felt more like singing his praise. Everybody singing his praise all day long. Don't you know I love just singing this song. Never in all my born again days have I ever felt more like singing his praise.
Was at an old time meeting so many years ago, a man of God stood up and he preached the word. And as they sang, "Why not tonight?" at that old altar I got right. Lifted up our praises to the Lord. How well I do remember my daddy at the altar, with many loved ones praying all around. There was shouting like I've never heard when my daddy found the Lord, as the congregation sang, "Just as I am." The old time meeting played where sinners found the Lord, the old time meeting place where saints of God rejoice. Just a little touch of heaven in those days. The old time meeting place with dinner on the ground, the old time meeting place where fellowship was found. Well, I remember the old time meeting place. There were 21 that waded out into that muddy river. They were singing, you could hear for miles around. Amazing grace, oh happy day, Jesus washed my sins away. And Lord, plant my feet on higher ground. The old time meeting place where sinners found the Lord. The old time meeting place God rejoice. Just a little touch of heaven in those days. The old time meeting place with dinner on the ground, the old time meeting place where fellowship was found. I remember the old time meeting place where sinners. Yes, I remember. making plays. The old time meeting plays.
You've heard about that stone that came down from Babylon. That stone that came rolling down for men to stand upon. With all of the patriarchs, as we've all now been told, would follow this stone where the milk and honey flowed.
They stood on that rock.
Yeah, they stood on that rock.
Where they stood on that rock.
That mighty solid rock.
Well, they stood on that rock.
Yeah, they stood on that rock.
Well, they stood on that rock.
That mighty solid rock. Heard about old Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego, and how the music was the plan. They wouldn't bow as they were told. It's not fitting that we'll bow now to all these idle things. You see, we're standing on Jehovah, well, he is their mighty king.
They stood on that rock.
Yeah, they stood
on that rock.
Well, they stood on that rock.
That mighty solid rock.
Well, they stood on that rock.
Yeah, they stood on that rock.
Well, they stood on that rock.
That mighty solid rock.
Now, hard against your soul. You've been pressed down, way down, as low as you might go. Just climb to your feet in the power of the Holy Ghost and stand on this rock. You see, it's heaven's mighty
hope. They stood on that rock.
Yeah, they stood
on that rock.
Well, they stood on that rock,
that mighty solid rock.
Well, they stood on that rock.
Yeah, they stood on that rock.
Well, they stood on that rock,
that mighty solid rock.
That mighty solid rock.
Oh, yes, they stood.
You. Not long ago I was thinking of home, and I wondered if Mama was there all alone. I thought I'd drop by like I'd done before, but the sound from within made me stop at the door. She was praying, a sound that the world seldom hears. Praying, her words were pleading and clear. The sound of her voice as she called my name brought tears to my eyes, my heart felt ashamed. Praying for someone like me. Walking one night and I felt so alone. My heart was weary from the troubles I'd known. I had noticed a church that was near, till the sound from within seemed to fill the a sound that the world seldom hears. Praying, the children that God loves so dear. Outside in the darkness I could not see, but I could picture them there on their knees. For someone like me, they were praying, praying for someone like me.
Heavenly wonderful, heavenly beautiful, that's what you are, Lord. Heavenly wonderful, heavenly beautiful, that's what you are, Lord.
Truthfully, I humbly pray, your precious Jesus in every way. Heavenly wonderful, heavenly beautiful, that's what you are. You're the glory of glories, holy, holy, holy. You have blessings and all good things come from. You're the treasure of treasure, you're God Almighty, there's no other. Lord, your heart must be made of pure love. Heavenly wonderful, heavenly beautiful, that's what you are, Lord. Heavenly wonderful, heavenly beautiful, that's what you are, Lord.
humbly pray your precious Jesus in every way. Heavenly wonderful, heavenly beautiful, that's what you are. Blessings and all good things come from. You're the treasure of treasure. You're God Almighty, and there's no other. Lord, your heart must be made of pure love. Heavenly wonderful, heavenly beautiful, it's what you are, Lord. Heavenly wonderful, heavenly beautiful, that's what you are, Lord. Truthfully, I humbly pray your precious Jesus in every way. Heavenly wonderful, heavenly beautiful, that's what you are, Lord. Heavenly wonderful, heavenly beautiful, that's what you are. That's what you are.
Thank you for your support. Today, we are offering for your enjoyment a package of gifts that we feel is our best offer we've ever made. We are offering a full-color hardback book of the Webster Brothers' memories, people we have met, places where we have sang, and more. Along with the full-color hardback book, you will receive 3 CDs, a Webster Brothers t-shirt, and coffee mug. We will also include a booklet by the late Reverend Billy Graham, Steps to Peace with God. All of this for a gift of $125 or more. Please mail your donation check to Webster Ministries, 300 East Main Street, Azle, Texas, 76020. Or you can go online at thewebsterbrothers.org and make your donation. Please help us continue our great work for the Lord Jesus Christ.
That I'm living, yet to live I die each day. To the world it seems so foolish, they just won't believe that Jesus came to save us all. He's the gift they won't receive. Him everything. He left heaven for me. No greater love has any man than to give his life for me. The one who knew no sin was found guilty for me. That God will see you through. So don't you get discouraged when this old world turns its back on you. Just look on a ahead, my brother, keeping this in mind. Keep your face to the plow, never looking behind.
Grace may be free, but it cost him everything. He left heaven for me. Sin was found guilty for me. Grace may be free, but it cost him everything. Well, my Jesus, he left heaven just for me,
just for me.
Who knew no sin was found guilty, guilty on that tree. Just for me.
When he returns in power and glory, all eyes will be on him. With the saints of the ages, his earthly reign as king begins. The river of life will be flowing, all nations will drink and live. We'll rule and reign in his holy name. God's plan when he returns. When he returns in clouds of glory with all the saints by his side, he'll be the King of kings and Lord of lords. He'll be the light. He is the life. Oh, brother and sister, wherever you are, don't miss this great return. Made a way, just kneel and pray. That's God's plan when he returns.
His name will be the Word of God. His power will be unmatched. His throne will be in Jerusalem. At his feet we'll worship at last. His righteousness will rule the day, for with him there's no need for night. He'll give us peace and sweet relief. That's God's plan when he returns.
When he returns in clouds of glory with all the saints by his side, he'll be the King of kings and Lord of lords. He'll be the light. He is the light. Oh, brother and sister, wherever you are, don't miss this great return. He's made a way. Just kneel and pray. That's God's plan when he saints by his side. He'll be the King of kings and Lord of lords. He'll be the light. He is the light. Oh, brother and sister, wherever you are, don't miss this great return. He's made a way. Just kneel and pray. That's God's plan when he returns.
God's plan when He returns.
Searching for peace in some boy, I was trying to blame all my ills on this world I was in. Surface relationships used me till I was done. And all the while someone was begging to free me from sin. He was there all the time. He was there. That I have the answer, my life is just starting to run. Sharing each new day with Him is a cup of fresh life. Oh, what I missed, He'd been waiting right there all the time. He was there all the time. He was there all the time, waiting patiently.
Was me.
Sometimes when I'm weary, Satan wars with my soul to get my mind off of the cross. And I start fighting battles Christ has already won. In a war Satan's already lost. Oh, if I ran so deep that it covered my soul. And Satan, you cannot enter in. Oh, if I hold fast to the foot of the cross, I'll be calling each life cleansing blood. If I'd stayed on my knees when Satan walks me, then he'd have to walk through the blood. And it's there in the blood I find mercy and grace, and all of the power I need. Oh, and if I hold fast to the foot of the cross, I'll be calling each night cleansing blood.
When Satan longs to see your demise, do not fear, shed no more tears, for salvation can be found in Jesus Christ. Just say a little prayer to the Savior. Tell him what your heart desires. save your soul from the fire. You can shout if you don't think he'll hear, or you can whisper your needs in his ear. Whatever you say, whatever the way, just one prayer is all that he will come to you time and again. Satan will fill your head with his lies. Do not believe, don't be deceived, for destruction's always on mind. When there's chaos surrounds you, when the darkness surrounds you, be still and follow his light. When you're lost and alone, Jesus will guide you home. If you don't think he'll hear, you can whisper your needs in his ear. Whatever you say, no matter the way, just one prayer is all that it takes. Savior, just one prayer is all that it takes.
Well, I've been sitting here all day long, wondering what to do, thinking about the days gone by and the trouble that I got into. Ever since I found the Lord, I thought I could face anything, but then I felt the tap on my back telling me to jump on in. I thought I might take a little dip without going too far in it. I felt the water at my feet getting deeper every minute. I know I've been forgiven, oh, my sins are washed away. I thought a taste would be alright, then I heard my Jesus say, no fishing, don't you bring up the past. No fishing, you're free at last. No fishing, you better reel it on in. No fishing, well, that's a bygone sin. You saved me once and you washed me clean. I know my life has been redeemed. Lord, I ain't fishing cause I got a clear vision of my own home. get an itch and you wanna go where the past seems wrong. Don't scratch too hard or you'll find yourself in the danger zone. Don't bait that hook and throw it in. You better change your mind. If you've been washed by the blood of the Lamb, stop and heed the signs. No fishing, don't you bring up the past.
No fishing,
we're all free at last.
No fishing,
you better reel it on in.
No fishing,
now that's a bygone sin. You saved me once and you washed me clean. I know my life has been redeemed, but I ain't fishing cause I got a clear vision of my own high. The sinner says take two steps back and dive right on in. The saved takes a stand for Christ and turns away from sin. No vision, don't you bring up the past.
No vision,
we're your friend last.
No vision,
you better reel it on in.
No vision,
now that's a bygone sin. You saved me once and you washed me clean. I know my life has been redeemed. Lord, I ain't vision cause I got a clear vision. My own life. No, 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 no.
I say I ain't
no
fishing,
fishing.
Now you hear?
No, 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 no.
I've been saved, sanctified, and been no delivered.
No, 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 no.
Hey, everybody,
there's no fishing.
He puts flowers on the hills. Your cup he gladly fills. How can you turn around and say God is dead? But when your stories have all been told, there's one thing I like. If God is dead,
if God is dead,
who's this living in my soul? He gives a shelter from life's stormy weather, gives us love to keep us together. When life gets like a ship on a raging sea, and when the stage of life grows cold, somebody helps us play our role. If God is dead,
if God is dead,
who's this living in my soul? If my soul had windows, I'd leave them open so the world could see the ugly scars upon those hands that bled for you and me. There's a bridge you can cross if you will. The toll was paid on Golgotha's hill. If God is dead,
if God is dead,
who's this living in my soul? If God is dead,
if God is dead,
who's this living in my soul?
Other side.
It's been a rough few days. I need to take some time. So they started out to do just that when they noticed all around the waves were fast and furious, and they thought they all might drown.
With a little faith and a lot of grace, he'll get us to the shore.
He's the master of the sea. He can calm the raging storm. He can heal the tattered soul, give us peace and so much more.
With a little faith and a lot of grace, he'll get us to the shore.
Yes, he will. They called his name, but not in faith. They were so afraid. Yet the master stood to calm the storm, and the wind and seas obeyed. Well, he pointed out they had doubt, yet they'd seen it all before. With a little faith and a lot of grace,
he got them to the shore.
With a little faith and a lot of grace, he'll get us to the shore. He's the master of the sea. He can calm the raging storm. He can heal the tattered soul. Give us peace and so much more.
With a little faith and a lot of grace, he'll get us to the shore. He can heal the tattered soul.
Give us peace and so much more.
With a little faith and a lot of grace, he'll get us to the shore. With a little faith and a lot of grace, he'll get us to the shore.
Yes, he will. Yes, he will.
Well, hello, everybody. This is Don and John Webster. We're coming to you live from our studios, downtown Azle, 300 East Main Street, Azle, Texas. And we are so excited to be with you today. And we're so glad that you have decided to be with us. It's an honor to have you, isn't it, Brother Don?
It is. Here we are in the metropolis of Azle.
Yes, metropolis. You know, we're about 20 minutes from downtown Fort Worth. If you get out here on the road that's right outside our building and go straight, you'll go right into downtown Fort Worth. So it's a pretty nice place. Let me know if you're hearing us okay. And we're going to do some shout outs and say hello to a few people that we know have tuned in. So, Don, why don't you start?
All right, let's see. First of all, we've got the infamous Claude Reed.
Wow.
So, Claude.
Claude.
Yeah, they say he's been doing a lot better since he got out of jail. And let's see. Darlene McConnell's tuned in.
Hello, Darlene. From our
Canada.
Sister, from another mister.
That's
up
right.
In West Guilford, Canada. You know, Darlene and Dale and their son Devin live out on a big farm. They raise strawberries and corn, and they tap maple syrup every winter. And when I used to go up there and have dinner with them, they'd have a big garden outside, and she would go out and pick the onions and the potatoes and the cucumbers or whatever they had, squash, whatever they had growing out there. And Don, that was delicious.
And their house burned down, didn't it?
It did, but they rebuilt.
They rebuilt, and they're on the same spot.
Place, same spot.
And it was neat because they have their maple syrup right there on the front porch, and it's the honor system. You have
That's
to
right.
put your money in the box and only take what you pay for.
That's right. Anyway, it's
Otherwise,
a really beautiful, beautiful place there. So thank you, Darlene.
What do they call their police there? The Mounted Patrol or the...
Well, they don't... No, you're thinking about the Royal Mounties, but that's something
okay.
different.
Anyway, the Royal Mounties will come after you on horseback if you don't.
Well, I see Nikki Skaggs
right.
tuned in. Hi, Sister Nikki. It's so good to have you on. Pearl Herman is on, but Pearl is also in our studio. She comes every week to the studio after she gets her hair fixed. So mm-hmm. she's in the studio.
Old Faithful is here.
Old Faithful, yeah.
I mean, and then we got Connie. Connie Ramirez is
yeah.
on. And sure. Connie, it is good to see you. I haven't seen you in a while.
That's right.
It's good to see you. Maybe she got over being mad at us for something. No, I'm kidding. You know I'm kidding. But it's good to see her on here.
Connie. I see Deborah Camp.
Deborah Camp.
She says, hello, Don and John.
Yes.
Hello, Deborah Camp. You know, they got their property, and they're going to be building a new church.
I don't know when they're going to break ground for that.
I'm not sure. We're going to break ground for our new building, not this Sunday, but the following Sunday.
Now, he's talking about at the Runaway Bay, the church.
Yeah, in Runaway Bay. Kate Hayes says, hi, gentlemen.
Hey, Kate.
Kate
tuned
and Fred
in from Canada as well.
Hopefully Fred's in the background there listening in, and we appreciate it so much. We love to see our Canadian friends, their names. They're like our family, but their names pop up. It's always good to see Kate Hayes' name.
Well, and inevitably, every week we have people that are watching that never chime in.
Yeah.
So if you're watching, please say hi to us and tell us. If we don't know you, tell us where you're watching from. We'd love to know.
That's right.
And then the other thing we need you to do is to hit that share button and invite others to tune in this hour.
That's right.
Because we're going to have some great music. I've got another trivia question.
That's right. Good. Another.
And this is going to be... it's going to be tough. It's going to be a hard one.
Okay.
This is going to be, you have to dig into that theological brain of yours and answer the question.
Or dig into Google. That's what I do.
No. the way I'm going to ask it, Google won't help you.
Oh, no.
I've got it figured out.
Well,
this
don't
week.
Make it so hard.
Yeah, it's going to be difficult.
You know, Lynn County Happenings is watching. I believe that's Lynn Lankford, I think.
Is it Lynn Lankford that does that?
I'm not sure, but they have been tuning in. So we want to say hello to all of our brothers and sisters in Tahoka, Texas.
Well, I saw on there where Ronnie Jolly is now the mayor. He is the mayor of Tahoka. So congratulations to Ronnie Jolly. There was a picture of him with his shovel. They got some rain, and he was cleaning out a culvert. So you got the mayor out there with a shovel doing some work. I'm impressed.
Well, Ron and his twin, Don, graduated from Tahoka High School.
Yep. And, 1982.
My mother worked there at the grocery store.
She started out at Rimrock, and then it went to it became Summit Venture Foods.
Okay.
Then I guess it went, I can't remember.
No, what, I thought she worked at that other one.
Then after that, she went to work down at Thriftway.
Thriftway. That's the one I'm thinking
of. Yeah, for Steve Sanders.
So we're Tahoka boys.
Yeah.
And we appreciate the Lynn County Happenings supporting our efforts.
Sitting in here with us is a lady from, she says Post, but she's really from Grassland. She's a Grassland. She graduated from Grassland High School. I'm kidding. They didn't have a high school. But she's a Pearl Craig. Herman.
That's right.
Y'all probably remember her from the early days at the Craig Pool.
That's right. The swimming pool right outside of Tahoka, between Tahoka and Post. Yeah. Yeah.
Grady and Sharon Williams. From Grassland. I didn't realize that.
Cottondale. They're tuned in.
Okay. Yeah.
They're
good.
Tuned in every week. We just love them for it.
Yeah. Grassland is, we've sang at the Nazarene Church out there many times. And just listen, there's nothing out there in Grassland but.
A church.
But a church and some good people.
And some good people. That's right. I was just going to say.
Freda Jeff Coach tuned in.
Freda. Oh, hi, Freda. Oh, we got to say hi to our friends from Over the Pond. They won last week's trivia question.
Yes, that's right.
Ennis and her husband, Simon Jones.
That's right.
Are tuned in from Penzance, England. And we want to say hello to you and how much we love you. And I'm so glad you won.
Now, let me just say, to save a few dollars, we sent it via a homing pigeon. So I don't know how long it'll take you to get your prize over the pond there.
I wouldn't worry about it.
But also tuned in is Patty Pendleton Langham.
Oh, good. Patty's watching. Hi, Patty.
Good to see you on here.
Patty had been here visiting Pearl for several days. And,
as they say over in Europe, her name is Potty. That's what she said when she was
That's
here.
That's funny.
But anyway.
Well, let's play a song, Brother Don. I'm going to play a song that, where's it at? Here we go. Don't Let Another Day Go By.
All on each day with no one to hold on to, and your ups and downs seem all the same no matter what you may do. If times of love and laughter seem so far away, don't let another day go by without Jesus, he's your stay. Don't let another day go by without Jesus, he's your stay. Don't let the enemy keep you down, don't let him have his way. All the love and joy you need today can be found in Jesus' name. Don't let another day go by, make him your everything. Trouble come every day as Jesus said they would. Our victory was won by him, there's no one else who could. He's the Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. Don't let another day go by before you let him in. Don't let another day go by without Jesus, he's your stay. Don't let the enemy keep you down, don't let him have his way. All the love and joy you need today can be found in Jesus' name. Don't let another day go by, make him your everything. If you're not serving Jesus, your time is running out. Surrender all you have to him, just lift your voice and shout. Tell everyone he's coming soon, be ready for the trumpet sound. Don't let another day go by, in him you're heaven bound. Don't let another day go by without Jesus, he's your stay. Don't let the enemy keep you down, don't let him have his way. All the love and joy you need today can be found in Jesus' name. Don't let another day go by, make him your everything. Don't let another day go by without Jesus, he's your stay. Don't let the enemy keep you down, don't let him have his way. All the love and joy you need today can be found in Jesus' name. Don't let another day go by, make him your everything. Don't let another day go by, don't let another day go by, don't let another day go by. Don't let another day go by.
All right. Don't let another day go by. Amen.
Amen.
I like it.
Or a night.
Or a night.
Or an afternoon. Or another minute.
The Lord of your life. Amen.
Amen.
Well, Don, who else we got over there?
Oh, let's see here. Let me get back on here. I was getting a text for work. So. Adrian Whitfield.
Oh, Pastor Adrian
and
his lovely wife, Marie, from up in Halliburton, Ontario, Canada.
Canada is making a strong showing today.
Yes, they are.
And then also we have Ellie Gray watching.
Oh, hi, Miss Ellie.
Miss Ellie Gray.
Thank you for tuning in. We are so grateful. We play her music on our program. She was played earlier. I think we played that old-time meeting place of hers.
Yep. That's right. Now, also, let's see, I was going to mention, we're up to 10, and so we want to get more on. So you hit that share button if you haven't already. But I was trying to think, when you were thinking of Ellie's song, I was trying to come up with her saying, that's why I was, she always says something like two strands of barbed wire or something like that. I can't remember. It's going to air on the radio or two strands
of barbed wire.
I can't remember.
Two cans and a string.
I can't remember. Ellie, you'll have to remind us how that goes. But anyway. But we're glad to have you all on here. This is, of course, the Friday Noon Gospel Hour. We're going to have to change the name, I guess, because it's really 2 hours.
Well, I usually just put on there the Webster Brothers. Then I put 11 a.m. 1 hour music and 12 a.m. the Don and John Show.
Absolutely. 12 p.m.
12
Absolutely.
P.m. Yeah.
Now we've got coming up. We're up to 11. Praise the Lord. Could we get just one more? So, but there's 12. Oh, see there, we got one more.
You know, we are going to be doing other programs.
Kerry Easley is watching.
Oh, hello, Brother Kerry and Pam, his wife. We're going to be doing some more programming. I'm going to start a program in the near future. I'll be announcing it. It's I'm not sure what I'm going to name it yet, but I'm going to be interviewing pastors from all around the area here and letting them talk about their life, how they were called into ministry, and then their church, and talk about their church and what they have going on. And I think that'll be real interesting to meet pastors. And, you know, the success of my ministry, the years that I traveled full time, which was about 22 years, the success of that was making friends with pastors. I made friends with every pastor in every church. And if they hear from your heart and believe in what you're doing, they tell their buddies about it. And before you know it, everybody's inviting you to come out and share. And that's what we want. We want people that will invite us to come out and share. Who's that, Pearl? Who's Deb? Tell her to come on in.
Oh, come on in. And the nice thing about it, you know, pastors are the gatekeepers.
That's right.
They watch over their flock, and they make sure that no one can come in and
do something damaging
in sheep's clothing. And that's right.
That's right.
And so, you know, you really need to, if you really want to serve this an area, then you really do need to know the
pastors.
You
need to know your pastors.
They need to know you.
That's right. That's most importantly. They need to know. What I used to tell all the pastors is I didn't come here to bring you something different. I came to add and to embellish what you have going on. So you use me however you want to use me. You know,
I walked in the next day and I seen John in there. He was cleaning the bathroom.
That's right.
They just put him right to work.
But I was just going to say that. That's right. They come up with ideas of their own.
Yeah.
And so how to use me.
That's
and
good.
I would go in pubs, and one of the most successful things that we ever did is usually on Saturday, I would be out in the community somehow.
Yeah.
They would come up with ideas for that. And on Sunday, I'd be in the church. But one of the neatest things we ever did over in England is we started in the town of Salisbury, England, where the Salisbury Cathedral is.
Where we get Salisbury steak from.
I don't know about that, but it sure sounds good.
I'm hungry.
And we did country gospel music line dancing. And they all... Every year it was bigger than the year before.
We did this
for 5 years. And the whole...
And you want to get to know the pastors around
the whole town. Well, this was their idea.
Just kidding.
The whole town would come out, and they would be dressed in their Western cowboy gear. And we would teach them the beginning steps of line dancing. And then when it came time to practice the dance, I would sing country gospel songs that I had recorded. And it was one of the greatest outreaches for these churches. They got to know people that otherwise would never get to know, got to invite them to their church. And it was a very highly successful thing that we did there at that time. Well,
we've got Kathy Noel Sharp on.
Oh, hi, Kathy. I'm glad you're on.
Continue to pray for Kathy.
That's
she says,
right.
Hello, everyone. Can't chat much. Love you all. So
that's fine.
We certainly need to be lifting Kathy up in prayer. And we'll do that today. If you've got a prayer request, be sure and type it in the chat room there, and we will include your prayer request at the end of the program. At the end of the hour here, we will be lifting you up in prayer. So be sure.
Well, Don, I'm going to play your song that we play every week, and we will be playing it every week because right now it's out on the radio, and we just got word that it's charting as of the month of June. It will be charting, and as long as it's charting, we'll be playing it to let everybody. You may have heard it before, but it should be a blessing to you. It's such a great song, and we're expecting it to do very well.
Yeah, and I just pray that people will be blessed by it. The one who knew no sin, we think about all that Jesus has done for us. I was talking to a lady this morning, and, you know, I said, I don't know if it's theologically correct. I think it is, but you hear preachers say it all the time. If we'd been the only one, or if there was only one, Jesus would have come and shed his blood on the cross, and meaning that he would die in our place and bear all of our sin. The one who knew no sin was willing to be counted as guilty for me and for you.
What a beautiful presentation. And this is just a great song.
Thank you. prison that I'm living, yet to live I die each day. To the world it seems so foolish, they just won't believe that Jesus came to save us all. He's the gift they won't receive. When this old world turns its back on you, just look on ahead, my brother, keeping this in mind, keep your face to the plow, never looking behind. Grace may free, but it cost him everything. He left heaven for me.
Just for me.
No greater love has any man than to give his life for me.
The one who knew no sin was found guilty for me. Grace may be free, but it cost him everything. Well, my Jesus, he left heaven just for me,
just for me.
Was found guilty, guilty on that tree. Just for me.
Well, praise the Lord. That's a great message in a song. I never get tired of listening to it. I listen to it quite regularly in my car. Not because of the singers, but because that is one of the best messages in the Bible, to think that Jesus did all that for us.
Amen.
That is just
Amen.
Incredible. What a benefit and what a gift that we have received from the Lord Jesus.
Yeah.
I wanted to mention to you, it's hard to toot your own horn, but I think it's necessary sometimes.
Well, you know, the Bible says, he that tooteth not his own horn, the same shall not be tooted.
I don't know. I don't know where that is.
That's in Koch Pat. That's in First
Don.
Yeah, First Don chapter 1.
Hey, we were honored. They had the Kentucky Fanfare, Christian Voice magazine in Somerset, Kentucky last week. And
we've got to go next year.
We were nominated in several places. They called our name out several times, and we won best Southern Gospel.
It was favorite.
Oh,
favorite Southern Gospel.
Southern Gospel
duo.
Yeah. And so it's a fan award. In other words, you have to have enough people that know you and listen to you to actually vote.
Yeah.
And so it's really one of the best little awards you can get. Last year, I think the Wilburn and Wilburn won it. And they have a lot of great singers that participate in that. It's a big thing there, and it's been going on. It was the 19th year. But that was such an honor. That's 3 years in a row now that we have won something from that. And we want to thank everyone who voted for us. If you're listening, we want to thank you for voting. And we just appreciate you so much. And basically, these awards that we get sometimes are just, it just gives our platform a little bit larger audience so that more people can hear what we just heard. The one who knew no sin, Jesus, became sin that we could become the righteousness of God. And so that's the key to this whole work, is to get that message out. So we are so happy that we are part of the industry and that we can produce, and God gives us music that we can share that lifts up Jesus. If you'll notice, that's our little motto right there, sharing Jesus with the world. And so that's what we want to do. Anybody that listens, we share it here at home, but we're on the World Wide Web. So there's a lot of people from Canada and England and other places. We've got somebody from Haiti, somebody from Uganda. We've got people
Canada,
tune in. Yes,
all over. I like the way you did that. The world. There it is, the world. With his glasses. Is. That's what I like to do. We're on the interweb.
You know, yeah. But it's just an honor to get to be an ambassador for Jesus
Christ. Absolutely.
And the Bible says we are all ambassadors.
That's
and
right.
So we're sitting
that's
here
right.
as ambassadors for the Lord Jesus Christ. And that's what we want you to know. And everyone that might happen to tune in and hear us, we want them to know that Jesus is our reason.
That's right. And we want to remind you, too, that if you have a prayer request, go ahead and type that in the chat room. We'll be lifting those up shortly. And then I want to give you an update. Darlene says, here's a praise report. My brother-in-law, Fred, went through his surgery and astounded the doctors. They removed the massive tumor.
Amen.
He went home 3 days later, all bruising and swelling gone. Could only tell he had, I can't really make out what that's saying. You know, sometimes when we're talking and typing it just,
yeah.
And it says, okay, he can carry on a conversation, remember things, and is able to walk. Praise the Lord. You know, that was a very...
Oh, you couldn't tell that he'd had brain surgery.
Oh, that's...
By the
okay.
bandage on his head.
Okay, all right. Sometimes when we read each other, when we send texts to each other, we have to ask for the gift of discernment and interpretation. And so we have to have that in order to read a lot of this
That's
stuff
right.
that we send to each other. But that is, you know, that was a serious surgery that he had. And
anytime they're working on your brain,
I'm
it's
telling
very
you,
serious.
If they got in my head, they'd have to really look around long and hard to find a brain up there. I know that.
Deb and Dan Johnson are listening.
Hey, Deb and Dan.
Hello to y'all. We love you. You know, they come to our church, and Dan
uh-huh.
comes out and takes pictures of all of our events.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
He'll
That's
be
good.
There to do the lake baptism uh-huh. and all of that.
Trish Boynton Blue.
Oh, hi, Trish.
Is watching.
Trish used to belong to the Crossroads Baptist Church where we
Yes,
used to
that's
go.
Right. I knew
She's
her.
She's a school teacher. Anna Roberts is watching. Hello, Anna. Thank you for tuning
now, Anna,
in.
Anna, I'm not sure. Tell us where we know you from, Anna. I would love to know. Tell us where we know you from, Anna. Okay. And sometimes we just forget because we're Websters.
Well.
And,
you know, when you don't see
I had
someone,
a sister-in-law one time that said, the only good thing about being, a sister-in-law said this, keep in mind, the only good thing about being a Webster is you don't have to marry one.
You know, I was just going to say, when I don't see someone regularly,
uh-huh.
it's hard for me to remember their name.
Yeah. Well, no, that's true.
But once
that's
I true. See someone on a regular basis,
yeah.
they're, you know, it catches on.
Yeah.
But it is difficult
it
and
is.
When you're dealing with lots and lots of names. It's hard to remember how you know someone until they tell you.
I think we can roll out the trivia question now.
Okay, let's do that.
We've got a tough one for you today.
Now, tell them what they're going to win.
All right. If you get this correct, then John will come to your home
no.
and clean your bathroom.
No. That's not true.
No? Okay.
Tell the truth.
All right. Don and John will come to your home and clean your bathroom.
Nope.
Okay. If you get this correct, you're going to get a coffee mug. Do we have any more coffee mugs left? We do, don't we?
No, we're giving out CDs.
Oh, we're giving out CDs. You win. He said tell you what you'd win, and then he tells me I can't get it away. I don't know what to do.
This is a trivia question. This isn't the promo.
What promo?
Never mind.
The promo with the shirt
yeah.
and mug?
Okay. Yeah.
It's okay, brother. Are you okay over there?
I'm okay.
All right.
It'll you be just all right. Go right ahead. I'm trying to keep smiling.
Okay. So we'll give you a CD.
No, how about we'll give two? You. We'll give him a couple.
Oh, great. Now he wants to give the farm away.
That's right.
Okay.
Give you a couple of CDs.
We've got a chair in here we don't need anymore. Why don't we just send that too?
We'll send that too.
All right. So here's the trivia question.
Here now, I'm going to play a song when he gets through asking it, so you'll have some time to find out.
Anna Roberts is Kathy Sharp's niece.
Oh, hi.
And that's right. And she's told us that before.
Oh.
Malin Richardson, who's a pastor in Oklahoma and an old friend of ours, is watching, and he wants the Webster Brothers to come to sing in Oklahoma.
Okay.
So I'm looking forward to that.
We'll do it.
And let's see here. So here's a trivia question. Who in the Bible,
ready?
Who in the Bible was the man who could not die before Christmas? Who in the Bible is the man who could not die before Christmas?
Boy, that's a tough one.
That's a tough one there.
I already know it. Not because he told me, but I know who he's talking about.
type it in.
You can figure it out. You can figure it out. In the meantime, we're going to play a song. This
yes.
is one of my favorite hymns I recorded years ago, and I hope you enjoy it. Oh, wrong one. Well, here it is.
I'd rather have Jesus than silver or gold. I'd rather have him than riches untold. I'd rather have Jesus than houses or land. I'd rather be led by his nail-pierced hand. I'd rather have Jesus than men's applause. I'd rather be faithful to his dear cause. I'd rather have Jesus than worldwide fame. I'd rather be true to his holy name than to be the king of a vast domain and be held in sin's dress when I
a force today.
Thank you for your support. Today, we are offering for your enjoyment a package of gifts that we feel is our best offer we've ever made. We are offering a full-color hardback book of the Webster Brothers' memories, people we have met, places where we have sang, and more. Along with the full-color hardback book, you will receive 3 CDs, a Webster Brothers t-shirt, and coffee mug. We will also include a booklet by the late Reverend Billy Graham, Steps to Peace with God. All of this for a gift of $125 or more. Please mail your donation check to Webster Ministries, 300 East Main Street, Azle, Texas, 76020. Or you can go online at thewebsterbrothers.org and make your donation. Please help us continue our great work for the Lord Jesus Christ.
See, people still type it in even though somebody's won.
All right. There you go.
I like that.
So do we have a winner, Brother Don?
We have a winner.
Oh, we do.
We're going to have to get some sound effects. You know what
I mean?
We'll have to figure that out.
I may have something over here. Go ahead. Okay. Hold on a second. Let me find it.
So
say something to him.
All right. Something to you. So anyway.
Sound effects.
Yes.
Yeah.
So
I can do something here.
We're excited because, like I say, we're working to do some fun things throughout this hour. We're trying to figure this out as we go. You'll need to use that when we announce the winner.
Okay.
All right.
Well, I'm ready.
All right. So the winner is the first person. Yeah, the first person to type it in correctly was Malin Richardson.
There you go, Brother Malin. He'll send it to us.
That's a long applause there. We must have a lot of people in the studio audience. So Malin Richardson is a pastor in Oklahoma. He better know the answer to that one.
That's right.
So congratulations. We'll get your 2 CDs in the mail to you, Malin. If you would, just message me with your mailing address, and I'll get that to Brother John and Sister Pearl, and we'll get that coming to you. And then... also, what was I going to mention? The name, Simeon. Simeon was the person who it was prophesied that he would not die until he saw the Messiah, till he held the Messiah to be born. And so, what was that? You don't do a symbol thing when I say the Messiah.
Well,
that's sacrilege.
Oh, okay.
Yes, I don't know. But anyway, so Simeon, so since Jesus was born on what we call now Christmas Day, then we can say that he was not going to die before Christmas.
That's right.
That's how we...
Well, it was kind of funny.
I am so sorry I mentioned sound effects.
Anyway,
we got Danny Jackson watching.
Well, hello, Brother Danny. He's another pastor.
Another good pastor.
Another great pastor. I mean, we were part of his congregation.
We've done revivals at his church. We've done revivals with him. I've done revivals with him. He was our pastor. Yeah, we love Brother Danny and Torin. Good to see y'all on here.
His lovely wife, Torin.
And then also we have Barbara Jaquist.
Oh, wow. You know, she painted her fence. Boy, does it look good.
It looks real good. Barbara Jaquist, I mean, she looks like she could get now, after seeing her work, if you would like your fence stained, you call Barbara Jaquist, and she will come and stain your fence for you. She did a good job. Did you see it, Pearl? Looked one of the nicest fences in Tahoka, Texas.
That's right.
And all because of her hard work. Let's see here. Okay, now, Roberta Hunter Thompson says she's watching from Warsaw, Indiana.
Salute!
It's been a while, Roberta.
Roberta, I'm sorry. I hope you had a good time on your trip. I saw some things on Facebook. It looked like you had a good time, but...
Was she in jail?
No!
Where was
she? She went to Somerset, Kentucky.
Oh, she went down to the...
She went to visit her friends and relatives somewhere else that was near Somerset.
Did she attend the...
She got to go to it for a little bit.
I mean, all that. That was good. Yeah. Now, Barbara Jaquess has just notified me that she is no longer available to... She is booked up on the fence staining. So she is no longer available to stain your fence.
That's too bad, Barbara.
But, yeah.
Now, they had a lot lined up for you. You made a lot of money.
If she has a can of spray paint, she might do some graffiti on your fence. I don't know, but she's not available to stain them.
Well, just so you'll know, what was the pastor's name from?
Malin Richardson.
Malin.
Brother Malin.
Just so you'll know, you're going to get a Webster Brothers CD and a CD that's entitled Country Gospel Memories.
Dr. Richardson.
Dr. Richardson.
Okay. Now, I don't know if he has his doctor or not, but you know, he's a doctor in my mind.
Yeah. Anybody that tries to get people saved to me as a doctor. Here's how I'll take Jesus. Brother over here sings the verses, and then I join in on the chorus, and it's a good old song.
As they gambled for that old robe that he wore, they chose a worldly trail. They didn't think of eternity as the soldiers drove those nails. Now will we learn from what they've done or make the same mistake? Jesus or the world, my friend, which one will you take?
I'll take Jesus. I'll take Jesus. Tried these earthly pleasures and they fail. When we see the gates of heaven, we'll hear the Master say, Jesus or the world, my friend, which one did you take?
When the pages of this old life have turned and time has rolled on away, the greatest things that I have done, they won't help me on that day. Well, they'll be to me just some old memory, and this we're gonna hear him say, Jesus or the world, my friend, which one will you take?
I'll take Jesus. I've tried these earthly pleasures and they fail. When we see the gates of heaven, we'll hear the Master say, Jesus or the world, my friend, which one did you take? I'll take Jesus.
Praise the Lord. I'll take
Amen.
Jesus. Amen.
Simple song with a powerful message.
That's right. Just to give you a little background on that song, that was actually put out by the Dixie Echoes when I was a little kid. Mm-hmm. And we've been singing it all of our lives. And so that's a great, great thing to let people know, I'll take Jesus.
Amen.
And then Don wrote a song to answer that. It says, I do take Jesus. What about you?
Right. That's right. We want to say hello to Sean
Constancio.
Hawkins Constancio.
Yes. Hi, Sean.
We saw
Sean
her
was just here. She was
a week ago.
Yeah. She came in from Austin and came into the her mom stayed here and watched the show live here at the studio audience. So we encourage everyone, if you're going to be coming near here, stop in between 11 and 1 o'clock any Friday And we have plenty of seating for you. We have a coffee pot if you need a cup of coffee. We have restrooms. We have it all.
We have it all.
So stop in and say hi to us and have a seat and enjoy watching the program with us.
And please don't throw any rotten fruit at us while we're trying to conduct our business. But anyway, hey, if you haven't hit the share button, be sure and do that. Coming up June the 10th, you want to mark your calendar. That is the next singing, the next big event here at the ministry headquarters.
Eagle Mountain Plaza, 300 East Main Street here in Azle, Texas. June the 10th, we're going to be featuring the Sawyer Family Bluegrass Band. They will be here with us. There is an admission. It's $8, a general admission. And if you're going to be in the area, please come out and join us. You're going to have a good time. It's really a lot of fun to see people up close and hear the music that they present. And it's such a blessing. And you'd be surprised. Sometimes I can't tell you how many times I've heard this, and I know you have too. People will come up to you and say a particular song, and they usually will tell you what song. That has touched my heart, and it was what I needed to get me through this situation I'm going through right now. And I just thank you so much.
Absolutely. And, you know, this holds probably about 150 people. It's an intimate environment setting or intimate setting and whatever. And so it feels really, you can just feel the presence of the Lord. You can enjoy the fellowship with one another. And it is a wonderful, wonderful time of coming together and enjoying the kind of music that we all grew up on, we all enjoy, that you don't get in a lot of places anymore.
That's right.
And I've know of several people, John, that were at our, remember last week we announced the Willow Park Baptist Church Friday Night Singing last Friday night. And there were 9 people from my community where I live, 9 seniors that came out to the Willow Park Baptist Church singing. And we had several people say, I'm coming to the thing in Azle in June, on June the 10th.
That's right.
So you want to be sure and get here and get your seat early?
Just so that y'all know, Azle has one motel. It's a Motel 6, but it's a nice one. It's newer.
We'll leave the light on for you.
But we've got that. But you can always stay in Fort Worth. We're 20 minutes from downtown Fort Worth. So there's plenty of places to stay, plenty of places to eat. And if you want to come in from out of town and be with us, you're welcome to come and join us.
Is there any room at your house?
No.
I thought he was a Christian.
I am. But I don't have any room. There's no room at the
end. No room in the end. No, I've been to his house. I promise you there's not any room.
You know, as you get older, you accumulate things.
That's right.
Trust me, I've accumulated so much that I couldn't handle anything else.
Yep.
Okay, let's feature a song here. I don't know what, let's see here. I think I'll do this one.
Okay.
He's coming back.
The Bible says to me, He'll be coming back to take me to my brand new home. In clouds of glory, Jesus I will see. He's coming back to take me to my brand new home. That's a promise my faith can hold on to. And sorrows are forever gone. He's coming back in clouds for me and you. But he said, I go to prepare a place for you, my child, a place of splendor where we'll live in peace. He's coming back to take us there. We must watch and wait.
when those clouds roll back, with Jesus we will leave.
He's coming back to take me to my brand new home. That's a promise my faith can hold on to. Where all wickedness and sorrows are forever gone, He's coming back in clouds for me and you. He's coming back to take me to my brand new home. That's a promise my faith can hold on to. Where all wickedness and sorrows are forever gone, He's coming back in clouds for me and you. Where all wickedness and sorrows are forever gone, He's coming back in clouds for me.
Amen. He's coming back. I'm telling you, it don't take long to look around and figure out that this old world's in bad shape.
It sure is. It
needs Jesus.
Talk about June the 4th for Barbara.
June the 4th. All right. So we will be at Faith Baptist Church on Sunday morning, June 4th. We'll be leading the worship at Faith Baptist Church in the Sunday morning service. And then after church, there'll be a meal, and then we'll do a 2 o'clock singing concert. So that's the plan. And then Sunday night at, I believe it's 6 o'clock, we will be
Calvary Lubbock.
Calvary Lubbock. You may know it as Calvary Baptist Lubbock, but Calvary Lubbock, they're on 82nd Street in Lubbock. We'll be there Sunday night at 6 o'clock. So you've got two great opportunities to come out and hear the Webster Brothers and be a part of the time just celebrating our relationship with the Lord. We just love Jesus, love to sing about Him, love to sing to Him, love to worship Him. So y'all come out and be with us. That's Faith Baptist Church on Sunday morning, June the 4th. And then that afternoon at 2 o'clock at Faith Baptist, we'll be doing our singing there. And then Sunday night at 6 o'clock at Calvary Church in Lubbock, we'll be singing there in their gym. They're going to do a meal and gym and that sort of thing. So we're going to do a lot of eating and a lot of singing.
That's right. That's going to be a great day for us.
It's going to be a great day. So y'all come out and be a part of
and
that.
And I know our Tahoka people will
now, that's
be able
June
to
the 4th. And then on the Friday, we have... That following Friday, we'll have our singing here at 300 East Main Street in Azle here at our location. And then that following Friday after the June 10th singing, that following Friday is going to be our third Friday night singing at Willow Park Baptist Church again. And we've got a group coming out from, they're coming down from, I think, Ohio or somewhere up north. Anyway, they're called the Open Heart Quartet.
Yeah.
So they'll be there in June. And so we're going to have a good crowd. We've got folks already calling the church and are bringing groups. And so that's going to be on June the 16th at Willow Park Baptist Church. So a lot of things coming up in the next few weeks for you to be able to come out and enjoy music.
Jot these things down with a pencil and a piece of paper. So if you can't come, pray for us when we're doing that, because we want this to really be a great outpouring of the Holy Spirit in each of these places.
Yeah.
I wanted to mention something else you can jot down. September the 22nd here. That's a far off. It's not as far as it seems, but it'll get here before you know it. September the 22nd, we're going to have a very special evening here. We're going to have the Inspirationals Quartet. And they've been together for many, many years, and they are really out there doing the big pro type thing, and they're going to be here to sing for us, and it's going to be a very exciting night. They just finished a brand new album, and I've got it here, and I'm going to do a cut off of it.
Yeah. And now, yeah, this is going to be a great night, September the 22nd. Make plans to be here. As a matter of fact, we've got to get it figured out because they have a following, so we hold about 150 people, so it'll probably be we'll figure it out. We'll figure it out and let you know. But That's September the 22nd. What song are you playing off
there, Cut, John? I'm going to play I Want to Brag on Jesus.
Yeah, now, this is a very cute song. I Want to Brag on Jesus. If you've, and you've not heard this, but listen. Talk. How many times do you get to hear rims on an Escalade in a gospel music song?
That's
this
right.
is a cute song. I Want to Brag on Jesus. Here it is.
I pulled up to a traffic light. There was a sticker on an SUV. It says, my kid's on the honor roll at the local elementary.
Where the next car over is a pickup truck. His sticker says, my kid can beat yours up. I guess you'll grow up to be a bouncer at a local bar.
But when it comes to bragging, I'll tell you the truth.
My heart leaps for joy when I'm spreading the news.
I was a hellbound sinner, yet he died for me. I just can't praise him enough. I want to brag on Jesus. I want to talk about the Lord. He raised me up with his holy word. I boast not of the things that I've done. All the good that I am is in the Holy One. I want to brag on Jesus. I want to talk about the Lord. Some Christians go to a football game. They yell so loud you gotta hold your ears.
When Sunday rolls around, there's a whole nother sound. A holy grunt you're never gonna hear.
You talk about how you got it made. 24-inch rims on your Escalade.
An attitude of gratitude is nowhere to be found.
Well, you can toot your own horn till you're blue in the face.
Guess that's just a condition of the human race.
As for me, I'm lifting my voice to the one,
the only one worthy of praise.
I want to brag on Jesus. I want to talk about the Lord. He raised me up with his holy word. I boast not the things that I've done. All the good that I am is in the Holy One. I want to brag on Jesus. I want to talk about the Lord. I will praise his name forever and ever. For his bond of love no one can sever.
I want to brag on Jesus.
The Lord, he raised me up with his holy word. I boast not of the things that I've done. All the good that I am is in the Holy One.
I want to brag on Jesus.
I want to talk about the Lord.
I want to brag on Jesus.
I want to talk about the Lord.
Oh, there it is. That group is called the Inspirationals Quartet. Yeah. And yes, Claude Reed talked about Bob Wills. Bob Wills started that group many, many, many years ago. There's been a full-time inspirational. There's been a full-time Wills on the road since 1938, proclaiming the good news of Jesus Christ.
That's right.
And with Pop Wills and all the different ones, and Bob Wills, Calvin Wills, all of them. But Bob Wills started this group, and they've been singing for many, many years. And Ron Wills, there's Ron Wills, who owns the Roadrunner Bus Company. You see those all over Texas. And then you got Don Wills, who is the pastor of the First Baptist Church in Fort Worth. And then you've got Bobby Lee Wills. And he is full-time, him and his wife, Annette. They travel the country and sing gospel music. And so they're just amazing people. So Wills, Ron Wills, Ralph Green, who's been with the Wills family and singing the Inspirationals for many, many years. And then you got John Rulipaugh singing the tenor. And you've heard John Rulipaugh, may not know it, but you heard him. He sang with the Dub Brothers for many years. He still fills in, or not fills in, but still sings with them when they need him. It's just a great legacy. These people have sang with everybody that's out there over the years.
Yeah.
They've got great stories they can tell you, and they're good friends and good
people.
They're
good people. They really are. They're good Christian people. And trust me, that's sometimes, not all the time, but sometimes it's a very difficult thing to get to know, is that not everybody that does this music is for Christ.
Yeah, and that's in all Christian genres. You see that in every kind of Christian music. Human nature is human nature, and
yeah,
sometimes this feeds the wrong part of us, and we start getting prideful and all that. And we weren't really meant for fame in that respect. Jesus is the one that needs to be famous. Amen.
Amen.
So we're going to brag on Jesus.
We're going to brag on Jesus.
That's what the song says. Now, listen, Freddie Jeffcoat says, pray for Sandy Taff with some health problems.
Barbara just said something about a lady named Miss Hogg.
Yes, Patricia Hogg.
Patricia Hogg.
Fell and broke her hip. She's a member at Sweet Street Baptist Church. Pat is, Pat Hogg. And sweet, sweet lady. So I hate to hear that. So we've got several things to pray for. Of course, we certainly want to give the praise report of Darlene's. It was her brother.
Mm-hmm.
and his surgery.
And we're so happy to have Kathy Sharp back.
Yes. Continue to pray for her.
Was that her niece?
Yes.
Okay.
And Anna Roberts, her niece.
But Kathy, we're glad. We hope that you're doing better. We know you're doing some better. And God has got you hopefully in recovery. And you'll eventually be back 100%. And we love you, and we pray for you, and we think about you every time we come on the air.
That's right.
Amen.
We have Sandra Lou Peretti is watching.
Yeah, hi, Sandra Peretti. I love that name.
And she says to please pray for her uncle. He's in the hospital and can't talk or walk. So, you know, we all come together, and there's always stuff going on in our lives. People who need a fresh touch from the Lord, whether it be financial healing, spiritual healing, relational healing, physical healing, mental healing, whatever it is. But Jesus is, that's why they call him, that's why the Bible calls him the great physician. Mm-hmm. There's nothing too great that Jesus can't touch and heal. Amen.
Amen.
Dan is starting rehab, Debbie says, to learn to walk again on Monday. Boy, he has been on a difficult journey, hasn't he?
Yes, he has.
We certainly need to remember them as well. Are y'all ready to go to the Lord in prayer? Let's pray together. Whenever I'm praying, you be praying. And as you hear prayer requests throughout the hour, we hope you jot them down and keep praying for them all weekend. So let's go to the Lord in prayer. Father, we just thank you for the privilege of prayer, first of all. Lord, we thank you that we can come to you. Lord, we can come to the very throne of God in times of need and pray in the name of Jesus. He's the great physician. He can think it, speak it, touch it, and it's done. And we thank you for that, Lord Jesus. And so today we come and we want to lift up these prayer requests, Father, that have been mentioned. First of all, we want to start with a praise report on Fred. God, we just thank you for the successful surgery. God, we thank you that his recovery is going well. Father, we pray for continued healing. And Father, we just thank you that we can say praise the Lord and give you all the glory and praise, Father, for Fred and the surgery that he was able to make it through because of your goodness and your grace, Lord Jesus. And Lord, today we want to continue to pray for Kathy. Father, as she battles cancer, God, we just pray for her today. God, we ask you to give her healing in her body.
Yes, Lord.
And Lord, we just love her. We thank you for her faithfulness. And Father, we just pray that you would touch her body and bring healing in Jesus' name. And let's see, Lord, we want to lift up Pat Hogg to you today. God, we love Pat. Father, she's been a faithful, faithful, faithful member. Lord, even though she walks on a walker, she's at church every time the doors are open at Sweet Street Baptist Church.
Yes.
Lord, we just pray that you would be with her and bring healing to her body. God, we know that hip surgeries and fractured and broken hips and things can certainly bring difficult times in our lives. And Father, I pray you'd touch her body, bring healing, and give her great recovery, we pray. Father, that she would gain strength and be able to come through this. Lord, and get back into church and get back into the fellowship with her friends and family that she loves so much there at Sweet Street. And we pray this in Jesus' name. See what other prayer requests we have here? We want to lift up Dan Johnson to you, Lord, as he begins to go into rehab to learn to walk again. Father, we pray for strength. Father, we just pray that that you would just engulf him with your healing power. Father, that your hand of healing would rest upon him. Father, that day in and day out that he would not get discouraged, but that, Lord, he would keep his eye on the prize of just working diligently and working hard, Father, towards the goal of walking and getting back to being independent. Father, we just pray that you would supernaturally just touch his body, Lord Jesus, and bring healing to him and give strength. Just as your word talks about those in Scripture, Father, who they're crippled, the Bible says their ankles and feet were strengthened, and he jumped up and he praised the Lord. And God, I pray that's what would happen in Brother Dan's life, Lord, as well, in Jesus' name. And Lord, today we pray for Miss Mary Brown as she broke her hip, Lord. Dear, we just pray that it was discovered, Father, during cancer, that it was discovered she has colon cancer, but it was called early. And God, we thank you for how those things are discovered early many, many times. Father, we thank you for that. And Lord, we pray for healing now for Miss Mary Brown from the surgery in her hip, Father, and from the healing from cancer as well. Lord, we just ask you to place your healing hand upon her. God, there's nothing too hard for you, the word tells us. Amen. And today we believe that. Today we claim that. Today we declare that, Lord Jesus, that there's nothing too hard for you to do. Father, we pray for Sandra Lou Peridi's niece who's having kidney problems. Lord, today we ask you just to touch her kidneys and, Father, to bring healing to her body. Father, that you would just relieve the pain, that you would open up the kidneys, that you would, Father, just work in there to remove any infection or inflammation. God, that you would just bring healing to her kidneys in Jesus' Amen. Name. Lord, we thank you. We thank you, Father, for all that you're doing in the lives of those who are gathered together today. And Father, we just thank you for that. And Brother John, have I missed any? Oh, Sandy Taft. Yes. Lord, as Freda has given us this prayer request, she has numerous health problems. And God, we just pray for Sandy today. God, we just love her. We thank you for her. And God, we pray that you would touch her body today. And Father, we just pray for healing in Jesus' name. And again, we declare there's nothing too hard for the Lord. And we thank you now for all that you're going to do in these lives.
Pray for Lord, Sandy today. Lynn.
And Lord, today we recovery. Continue to pray for Sandy Lynn and her recovery. Father, from the brain surgery, the tumor that was removed successfully. God, we pray you'd continue to strengthen her and raise her up. And God, that she would be able to continue, Father, to serve you and to enjoy life and to just be the daughter and the friend and the grandmother and all the things that she is to so many, God, that you would raise her up and just give healing in her body.
Scott Berger.
We thank you for it. And Lord, today we lift up Brother Scott Berger to you. And God, we know that when we look at a situation, we get discouraged and we get depressed and we say, oh no, but God, we know that in your economy that there is healing. Father, there's nothing too hard for you. And today, Lord, we want to thank you for Scott's healing. We just want to declare it, Lord. We want to thank you for it, Lord Jesus. Father, we pray you'll touch his body, God, and you'll bring that healing. Father, that there is no greater name under heaven whereby men must be saved. There's no other name that's greater than the name of Jesus. Even cancer has to bow to the name of Jesus. And so, Lord, we just lift Scott up to you today, and we just, Lord, ask you for that healing power to just run through his body even now, Lord Jesus, that you would bring healing to him. Father, I love reading about the miracles in the New Testament. Lord, there is nothing too hard for you, and you are all-powerful, all-knowing, and you're present everywhere at the same time. And we just, Father, we just lean on you right now for your healing power in all of these that we've mentioned to you today.
Amen.
And we pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. And Kathy, I got your message here. Kathy Sharp has not had her surgery yet. It's Tuesday.
Tuesday.
And so when we pray for her, we just want to remember that she is about to go have her surgery. And we pray that
Amen.
The doctors will be the hands of our God and will do everything as it should be
Amen.
Done. And
Amen.
Healing will come quickly, Kathy, yeah. And recovery will come quickly, and you'll be back laughing and cutting up with the rest of us.
That's right. Amen.
Soon. And soon. So we love every one of you. We're going to close out with our last song, which I'm going to do. It's something that Brother Don sings. Let's feel that spirit.
Yeah.
Tell them about that song.
Yeah, this is a song that Kevin Spencer recorded many years ago, and I really have always liked it. And it's an up-tempo song. And what this is the audio that was taken off of a live show that John, or a show that John used to do on television in Lubbock, and called Praise Today. And we sang this song on that program, and it's called, I had a live band back then, and we were just a bunch of guys, and we were just serving Jesus, and we were legends in our own mind with our live band. But I love this song. It's called Let's Feel That Spirit Again. Hope y'all have a blessed weekend.
Amen.
Be in the Lord's house on Sunday, and we'll see you next Friday.
Yes.
I went to a church house this morning, like so often I love to go. I was looking for that old-time religion. I knew that it was good for my soul. Show it that we love.